Yo, what's going on, Bleach fans? We have some very interesting news to share with you today, and I'm going to run it by you because, honestly, I do need some help, I think, because I'm kind of at a loop here. So, if you haven't seen my Rukia video that I've done previously talking about the extended backstory about her, I feel like this is an extension upon that because it's kind of related to Rukia in some way, shape, or form. You'll understand why soon. So, today we had a Q&A in regards to Byakuya and Ichigo's fights. The one in Soul Society around about, you know, episode 61 or 62, something along those lines. And the question goes as follows, that when Byakuya used his Senkei, which is the room or that space where he does a thousand swords or whatever, the question goes as follows. Byakuya said that Ichigo was the second ever person to see Senkei Zenban Zakura, but who was the first one? The answer, of course, from Kubo was, this will not be answered here. Which is interesting because this was kind of the same answer that we got in regards to Rukia's name within the manga being a different font. Now, of course, that isn't entirely anything to really go off except for the notion that I said, well, the Vizards had two different fonts, so why did Rukia? And it was a very confusing topic because we didn't really have a lead to go on besides many of the comments saying that it was possibly something to do with the Hogyoku. I disagree, but that's the fun of having these discussions. So, the fact that, yes, Ichigo is the second person to see Senkei, I decided to go into the chapter a little bit more. To which the chapter, Byakuya actually says, Senkei is whom I have sworn to kill by my own hand. And at first I was like, oh, well, maybe this is, you know, Yamamoto, because obviously every captain has got to show their Bankai to a bunch of other captains. That's kind of like the ritual towards being qualified as a captain to prove that you can use Bankai and present it within a way which isn't too dangerous, I guess you could say. We don't really know the full procedure of showing Bankais to a bunch of captains, but that is one of the requirements. But then I thought, well, if that's the case, then one, it would be more than Yamamoto, it would be multiple captains that he'd be showing it to, and he's talking about a singular person here, and he's talking about it in a malicious and vengeful way. So clearly he hasn't shown this to any other captain, as far as we know, in terms of becoming a captain himself. So then I thought, oh, well, maybe it's something to do with Hisana, maybe something to do with training. Again, that wouldn't make sense either because, again, he's shown this to people who he's vowed to kill. So this kind of puts me back a little bit and think, well, okay, maybe this has something to do with his dad. So his dad being a lieutenant of Genrei, which is Sojin, who is, I had to look into the MAST data book to get more information. He was killed within battle. I just had to refresh upon that because really there is not too much to know about Sojin at all. So he was a kind guy. He wasn't really fit to fight because of his personality, and we know that, you know, he was very talented being in the Byakuya Kuchiki household or clan, or the Kuchiki clan. So how did he die? Well, we don't know how he died, and it is pretty much, I would say, maybe a mystery that we didn't really ask for, but maybe an interesting one nonetheless. So when I think about who Byakuya may have had past beef with, I mean, we saw the Turn Back the Pendulum, which was 100 years into the past, with Sosuke Aizen, and his big betrayal with Shinji, blah blah blah. We all know that. If you've watched the series, hopefully you would have known that. Byakuya was a kid, and he was quite a happy kid. We didn't see the reason to why he turned out the way he did, his seriousness. Maybe it was his training with Genrei after his father's death. We don't really know. There is a gap between the present and 100 years ago, which tells me it's possible that Byakuya has possibly found out who killed his dad and possibly used Senken on them. However, it's interesting because in the Q&As to Kubo's website, the Q&As are very picky and choosy. Like, it's quite obvious they're avoiding the question of what does Ichigo's Bankai do, or they're leaving it till very, very later on. So, and I know for a fact that question has been asked so many times that because they are picking and choosing, that it's only right. If it was something he didn't want to answer, he would have ignored it. However, he's gave it to us here, just like the Rukia one, and said, you know, I mean, the answer's a correlation. The first one you could say, oh, okay, translation error. You know, he's saying, oh, he's not going to draw it, or maybe he'll draw it, you know, as like a passive comment. But he said it again, he's not going to answer it here. If it wasn't something you were going to delve into later on in the story, or later on in the future, then you would have just said it. You know, you would have just said, oh, it's because of X, Y, and Z. It was this person who I haven't drew yet. Lol, maybe I'll draw something in the future. But no, he's like, he's keeping it very secret. And I find that really, really fascinating. Also, within the Q&A too, he also talks about that Zangetsu's name was also blacked out by ink, which we all know. Apparently, that was Ichibei's doing. Very interesting, because that's some really cool foreshadowing. And the reason why I'm not delving too much into it is because I'm just going to give the passive comment of it would be really cool if that was kind of foreshadowed within the anime. I think it would be a really nice touch. But in regards to Rukia and the reason why I said Rukia and Byakuya are kind of similar is because, well, they both are part of the same household. Rukia's obviously got a secret. Byakuya clearly has a bit of a secret that Kubo wants to draw. So, is it possible that we'll get a flashback within the Thousand Year Blood War arc? Is it possible that we'll get a mini arc after the Thousand Year Blood War arc? Will Kubo do side stories? Will we get another data book? It's quite clear that there's going to be more Bleach to come. It's been very, very apparent at this stage, given some of the inquiries that we've been getting, and I'm all for it personally. And I generally do think a lot of it is going to be extra content for the anime, without a doubt. We've already discussed that there's going to be added scenes within the anime, not including the light novels, such as, I mean, it could have been on Tokinada, but he didn't kill Tokinada. But that would have been interesting if there was the Tokinada household had some beef with the Kuchiki household. That would be interesting in and of itself, because they're both powerhouses within their own right. So it's interesting, and that's why I'm coming to you guys to say, what kind of beef does Byakuya have in the past that could have correlated to being the first person that he used Senkei on? And how do you think that turned out? I was going to say maybe it was something to do with Hisana's like family or what, I'm not sure. But there's clearly a connection between the two characters, Rukun and Byakuya. And I'm all excited for it. So that's really all I really have. It's very, as I said, very apparent we're going to get more stuff in the anime. And I'm all for ink canon filler, and I'm all for Kubo's hand in this process. So I'm very excited. There's going to be a lot more stuff to talk about in the coming weeks. I'm very excited. So tell me your guys' thoughts in the comment section down below. Like the video if you want me to keep you updated on the news and whatnot. And are you guys excited? Of course you are. Yeah, of course you want more backstory. Why wouldn't you? I'm going to catch you more focus later. You guys, of course, have this fine day. I've been Hanson, as always, people. Peace out.